Hi, I am Jan. Get ready to unlock the power of large language models, or LLMs for short, in just 30 lines of code. In this video, we will build an app without a vector database that can answer user queries using a corpus of documents. We'll ingest documents, reprocess them, and automatically create a blazingly fast vector index to retrieve relevant snippets for each query. We'll then connect our app to OpenAI API, or for data privacy, we'll use offline models available at Hugging Face to generate human-like responses using advanced language models like the GPT-4. The best part? Pathway handles all the complex ML infrastructure and real-time indexing under the hood. First, let's see the system in action. In the top pane, we see the Pathway textual interface displaying the most important properties of a Pathway run. We see the number of messages processed, the latency with which the system would respond to a query, and latest log messages. Let's now ask the question. The map exposes the REST API, thus we will query it using CURL. How to connect to Kafka in Pathway? We see that the system is processing the message. It's issued call to OpenAI services and produce an answer. To connect to Kafka in Pathway, you can use the Pathway.io Kafka package. Package provides the connector for reading messages from Kafka streams. This is indeed the correct answer. Let's now see how the system is implemented. The whole program is implemented in the contextful chatbot.py file, which you can find in our GitHub repository. Remember to store it to know about additions to these tutorials about using language models in Pathway. The app is a microservice. The implementation is basically divided into two parts. In the first part, we are reading a collection of documents, then embedding each document by calling the OpenAI embedding service. We are then building a nearest neighbor index over the embeddings of the documents, such that we can retrieve documentation snippets relevant to the user query. We then create the REST endpoint that will be used to serve user queries. Every arriving query is first turned into a vector using the OpenAI embedding service, in the same way as documents. Then we use the index to retrieve the relevant documentation pages, the nearest neighbors of the query in the vector space. We use the relevant documents to create the prompt, which will run through the GPT-4 or GPT-3 service to generate the answer to the user. Let's see the full code. We start with creating an embedding model, in this case using the OpenAI API. We use the JSON line connector to read documents from a folder. It can also read documents from a local drive or from S3. It can also read documents from a Kafka topic. For all these cases, the demo will work in exactly the same way. We then run the documents through the embedder to get the embeddings and create an index suitable for retrieval of matched documents. Then we create the REST connector. Every query gets embedded and we retrieve its context. The relevant documents are taken from the index. We build the prompt in the relevant documents. We run the prompt to the GPT model and send the response to the user. Let's see again the system in action. We are asking about using the Bayesian with Pathway. We see that the query is put through the embedding service. It then creates a prompt. The prompt is run through the OpenAI GPT service. And as soon as it finishes, we start to see the answer. You can use the pathway.io.debezium.read function to communicate with Debezium. We will now see that the system is reactive not only to the queries, but also to changes to the documents. Let's see what the bot can tell us about using large language models. How to use LLMs in Pathway. Again, the query is embedded, nearest neighbors are retrieved, and a prompt is sent to the GPT to answer the user. Let's see what the system can come up with. Oh, it actually confuses the LLMs with Leuven-like method, so a graph clustering method for which Pathway is also a very good choice. Make sure to read our documentation on Leuven community detection graphs. But why is it happening? In fact, the documentation snapshot we used contains no information about large language models. We cannot answer the query because we don't have a relevant document in the corpus. Now, suppose that the indexing service runs and creates a description of the new documentation pages. I have created such a document. In the extra documents, we have one document which says that to use large language models in Pathway, all you have to do is call functions from the Pathway stdlib ML NLP module. Now, let's copy this document into the data folder. We see that as soon as the document is copied, the system starts to index it. In fact, this will also happen if in your data lake, a batch extraction process puts the new files into a folder or appends new data to a data lake table, or if a new message comes over a Kafka topic. In all those cases, the pathway program reacts and reindexes the document, effectively adding it to a database. In this respect, pathway replaces a vector database, applying the same preprocessing consistently to all the documents as they come. All right, once the document is indexed, let's see if the bot will be correct about language models. We issue the question again. We see that it's calling the OpenAI GPT model. And success. It now says that we need to call functions from the pathway stdlib ML-NLP module. This is exactly what we mean by reactive programming. To implement the logic, you are writing as if the data were static. However, pathway reacts to changes of all the input tables, updating the responses in reaction to every change. Moreover, computations in pathway are persistent. Let's see what happens if the chatbot got killed. Kill it and restart. Please notice that the system is immediately ready to answer queries. No documents were re-embedded using the OpenAI service. We call this incremental computation. When a system restarts, it performs only the amount of work necessary to accommodate the new data that may have arrived when it was down. In this case, no new data arrived and no work was done. No API calls were issued. The system reuses all the previous results from the previous run. Let's verify that it is still able to respond to questions. Yes, it works. Thus, in this demonstration, we have shown the basic microservice in Pathway. It reacts to new user queries, providing to each query a response, but it also reacts to the database of documents, updating and reindexing documents as they are added, either as files to a folder, or as messages to a Kafka topic, or as revisions to a cloud lake storage table.
Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to stay our GitHub repo. We'll be publishing more tutorials soon on optimizing your language model application, including fine-tuning language models based on user feedback, splitting the app into modular index building and query processing pipelines, deploying the app to production. Stay tuned by subscribing to our channel, or feel free to leave any questions on GitHub or discuss on Discord. Happy coding!